colors that I found. Hopefully I don't mess it up too much so I can later put it in my bathroom or somewhere in my house. At least when I bought it, it looked really great. Let's see how well I can do. Welcome back to Colorlytical. I hope we can enjoy this journey together with humor and honesty. Let's connect with the life lessons we have taken from our experiences. Positive, negative, and sometimes both. As I am recording this audio, Jonah Hill, the actor, has released a documentary on Netflix called Stats with his long-term psychotherapist. It blew my mind. This is the documentary that we all need to be part of and watch because we have the stars and famous people so idealized that we don't realize they're actually just normal human beings like you and me. And they probably have as many insecurities as you do. At the end, sorry, spoiler alert, Jonah is asked why he's doing this documentary. And he says, well, so I can share with the world what I learned through years of therapy. Because it helped me, so hopefully it helps you too. Wow, I got so inspired to keep going. He said he wasn't sure of the format of... Personally, I wasn't sure of the format of this. Well, but after watching Jonah, I felt his therapist's pain. I could never talk to my parents about this. I wish there was the space to do it while they were alive. I realized how this is my biggest fear, that I don't try enough to have this space with my family. And this is one of the reasons I don't want to have kids right now, if any. I have so much to unveil in my own life. I'm not ready to teach anybody so pure and naive what the rules are until I can make peace with my past. What a beautiful way of combining Jonah's film passion with his life lessons. Maybe in the future I can do that with mine. In the meantime, while I'm not a millionaire, I'll stick to the books, podcasts, and YouTube channels. As I am saying all of this, it's making me sad that my own parents ignore the fact that I go to therapy because they think I am the one in the family with mental issues, like the black sheep. I am the weak one. It makes me sad that the day I told them I was going to therapy, they never mentioned the subject again, never asked me again, never wanted to know about this taboo subject. Even if I send them videos or books to look at, they never even reply. They don't ask anything or show any interest. They feel that the more they ignore a subject, the better we will all be. And I've seen them react this way in family conversations, or let's just say, fights and discussions. We don't acknowledge the problem, we put them in the back. So tomorrow we forget about them and we don't acknowledge them. For them, I am an outsider with very radical thoughts that are dangerous to their routine. In my family, I feel lonely and have no topics to talk about. Whereas with my partner, we challenge each other with every experience, thought, opinion, etc. We talk about anything and everything, and I would love to hear your opinions and if you're in a similar situation, just so I know your perspective. And yes, I've tried it all. I went to therapy with them once, and then never again. And they don't want to try on their own. Who knows? Maybe we're so many, we can make a podcast about how to move forward on this. But yeah, I can't help it but feel sad about older just different ones. But at least we're breaking the generational traumas and trying to be better. Let's face it, maturing intellectually is more difficult than becoming financially independent. Think about that. Kids shouldn't have the responsibility of fixing their parents because they can't. Only them can fix themselves. So, in this YouTube channel, I am talking about all the things I wish I knew growing up to prepare me to be a parent myself one day. I am choosing to overcome problems, not to be a victim. What type of society will we have if we all chose this? Yes, these are my wounds, and this is my channel. I am not expecting you to like it or dislike it. I mean, I really hope you give me a thumbs up and you share it. But I'm just hoping that even just one single person can identify with what I say and can relate to the stories I tell. We are in 2023, but still with traumas from the Industrial Revolution era. Therapy is a taboo topic in older generations, and we're lying to ourselves if we say the contrary. What's the cure then? Courage. Courage to unlearn. Courage to learn new things. Courage to a new way of life. The actress Michelle Yeoh said this year, "My dream was to come to Hollywood until I got here." The point of this channel is not to find answers at all, but to continue asking new questions, to process our past and keep evolving into the future. With the rise of the internet, social media, telephones, etc., we are losing ourselves. We are losing our ability to know who we are and what it is important to us. We are creating a global machine in which each of us is a mindless, unreflexive cog, relentlessly driven by the speed, noise, and artificial urgency of the wired world. E.O. Wilson proposes a bold suggestion that half of our waking minds be designated and saved for quiet reflection. Somehow, we need to create a new habit of mind, as individuals and as a society. Non-therapy, books, podcasts, meditation can help with this. I never understood what freedom meant. Living in a world where we are the only animal who pays to live on Earth. I never understood what it meant, with all the laws and enforcements around it. With all the banks making you sign deals where you owe them your soul until you die, just to be able to live in this planet of the first place. To be able to eat, to have a roof, water, etc. In fact, how can the most capitalist country in this world believe they are the ones with the most freedom in the world? How can their laws and bases be on top of you chose to live with. And boy, do I feel free now. It took me a while to understand that therapy is not a weakness, but a strength. And it makes me sad that still some people around me think that you're very weak and you have a very weak mind if you need help from others. Being vulnerable and sharing your life is a brave and powerful act. Becoming in touch with your emotions and every aspect of yourself is also incredibly liberating. We need a mental attitude that values and protects stillness, privacy, solitude, slowness, and personal reflection that honors the inner self. Because social media does just the opposite. And when we do so, we give ourselves a gift. It's interesting to hear generations like my parents now realize how different I am from my sister, my siblings, or even from them. Well, yeah, that happens when someone works on themselves rather than the rest when they don't. Even though people who don't go to therapy will always think that they are not the issue, of course. If you have ever experienced a narcissist in your life, I'm sure you have confronted this DARVO, DARVO, deny, attack, reverse, victim, offender. Let me put you an example. Alice, I'd like to tell you about how I felt when you spoiled my birthday party because you made a scene after dragging me and my friends to a club we didn't want to go. To which Beth replies, that never happened. I don't know what you're talking about. Alice, it did happen. I remember it like it was yesterday, and I still have not forgiven you because it hurt me so much. It was my 28th birthday, and somehow you made it about yourself. You shouted at all my friends in front of me and told them that for your balls, they do whatever you say, meaning going party. We all had agreed already to play some games, and you shouted to everybody out of my house. In fact, not only were they scared, but more than half of the party left home after your behavior. I was embarrassed and frustrated that I couldn't celebrate my birthday as I really wanted. Beth, it was your fault you didn't have a happy face after everything I did for you. You're so ungrateful. I even brought you a cake. I prepared a surprise party and all your friends came because of me. Alice, I was not happy. I was tired because I had a 5K run in the morning for the first time ever in my life, and I was scared that if we didn't do as you said, you will get upset, which you did anyways, like you do in every family trip. Literally, all my friends left and you didn't care because we did as you said. Beth, well, I was upset with you because your behavior upset me for 2 straight days. You should have at least said thank you for the party I put for you, and you should have apologized to me. You're so sensitive. Please let me know in the comments what you think about this situation. And yes, it did happen. What a narcissist person needs is to pick on you until you react, so they can use that reaction against you. I see it all the time, where somebody makes a joke, actually quote unquote a joke, because it's just pure bullying, even when they think they're just teasing you and they're just being funny at the other person. course, the other person is feeling ashamed in public, so they will react with exactly an excuse for the narcissist to get upset or to tell them, seriously, can you take a joke? Somehow, they are the offended ones and will make sure everybody else is on their side against the bullied. But if you don't let them affect you, change your mood. Control your reactions. In fact, if you don't react at all, you can become the best self of yourself and they will be defeated.